Hi friends, I wish to call students to be friends, and for today's session I would like to introduce you to the subject, a very important subject for our department, process control. This particular subject, process control, is an updation of control system. Control system, we look into the stability of systems, we look into how the system can be modeled, what are the various tools which will be used for measuring gain margin, phase margin, how the block diagram could be reduced, so on and so forth. Process control specifically relates to four important parameters. The four important parameters would be temperature, pressure, level and flow. These four major parameters plays a very crucial role in industries, especially chemical industries. And all chemical industries comes under the purview of what is called as process industry. Here, a process is something which could be continuous or it could be in a batch. There are various types and there are various strategies to control also. The objective of this session is to introduce to why process control is necessary, based upon which we can go in for further understanding on how to perceive the subject and thereby take it accordingly. Well, process control, as I said, first and foremost, it's about modeling a system. Let's consider a very simple system which could be a single tank level control. Control is something which we all have studied in control system. That would have been some mathematical expressions. But here, I wish to control something in a real time. Here, the objective is to control the level in this tank. The level in this tank, let us assume, is going to be having a range from 0 to 2 meter. And I am interested in controlling the level at 1 meter. That is my intention. If this is to be controlled, obviously there needs to be some mechanisms for the same. Assume that we do not have any type of automations involved. How can we control? A human being can have an idea about the level which he can see through a sight glass. Initially, the level may be nothing, which is going to be zero. What is it he will do? He will try to increase the level. How can he increase the level? Any of the inflow or outflow should be under our control. Here, let us assume that outflow is not under our control, which means Q0 is not under our control. So that can be depending upon some other process which can suck liquid from here. Then we need to set some boundary conditions. What is the boundary condition here? The boundary condition which I need to set here is Qi max will always be greater than or equal to Q naught max. The answer is not true to this. The level can be set. This will be the range 0 to 5 meter cube. And then there will have to be some boundary condition. The boundary condition is that at any point of time, the maximum inflow should be greater than or equal to the maximum outflow. Only then the probability of increasing the level would be better. The vice versa is when you get through the tank, you never get higher than the probability to increase the level. To justify about it, if Q0 is going to be 0 to 5 meter cube per hour, obviously my inflow should be having the capacity at least 0 to more than 5. Here I assume it is going to be around 10 meter cube per hour. Now coming to the practical aspect of it. The practical aspect is assuming the tank is zero. There is a valve here which can derive the content inside this either by putting a pump and sucking it out, or through gravity the liquid can be flowing out. So in that particular context, I don't have control over this. Obviously, what is going to be the situation? The situation is that this inflow should be greater. Let us now assume that the outflow here is going to be around a value 2.5 meter cube per hour. If this is the potential, then As a human being, what is it I will do? I will have a device which can control this. Obviously, what I will do? I will try to increase this device so that the flows will be maximum. When the flow will be maximum? When the valve is fully open. When the valve is fully open, what happens? The flow will be 10 meter cube per hour. When this is going to be 10 meter cube per hour, obviously, against an outflow of 2.5 meter cube, the level will begin to increase. As the level is getting increased, when I am around this area of 0.8 or 0.9, probably I will think of regulating this flow. When I try to regulate this, this particular value of level can go above that and then it could get settled. What do I mean by settling? Will I close the valve completely? No. At that point of time, when I need this value to be exactly maintained at 1, my inflow should be equal to the outflow, which correlates to the outcome that rate of change of height will be equal to 0. If dH by dt is going to be a positive number, the level increases. If it is a negative number, the level is decreasing. Now I control it. I cannot put millions of human beings all over the world 24/7 to control all these aspects. Now I have to go to mechanisms. The mechanism aspect for this would be, I will have to measure the level when I use a sensor. Probably this will be called as a level transmitter. This will give some information to a processor. This processor, let me assume it is going to be a personal computer. For example, personal computer. This computer will have some algorithms. That algorithms, I will explain on the overall spectrum of the subject, will decide on how it should act like a brain. Based upon the decision which is going to be made by this processor, a signal will be given to the element. If I am able to establish this, then I can replace a human being. Machines can take care of it. When machines are able to take care of this, advantage number one, I do have the possibility of recording the data. I do have the possibility of having analysis being made. I can have a trending, I can have a historization based upon which I can do a better troubleshooting. This is going to get reflected. I can go on in this subject, so I can just go on for talking. Now I will try to make some generalizations. Before getting into the generalizations, I can very easily now design a mathematical model. I'll come to it. What do I mean by a mathematical model? Some equations which I know to my knowledge, how it can be fitting in here so that that culminates into a model. First simple thing, what is it I know? The difference between the inflow to outflow is always proportional to rate of change of height. I can use this condition, that's why I will say Qi minus Q0 will be equivalent to A dH by dt, where A is the surface area. So depending upon the surface area, I am equating this as a proportionality constant. This I can take it as equation number one or the assumption. Then I need to get a model. If I need to get a model, I will have to go for the next situation. The next situation is something else I need to define. Here I will go for a Q0. If you look into Q0, this Q0 will be proportional to H, where H is nothing but this height. So, if I want to equate this, then I will say Q0 is equal to 1 by R into H, where R is the resistance of this particular valve also. Using this, I can substitute for a value here, and ultimately, when I take the Laplace, maybe we will go into those things a little bit later, you can trust me, my dear friends. When I try to substitute this, this will be Qi minus of 1 by R into H is equal to A into dH by dt. Right? When I do some reworking, etc., as concerned, that we will put it in a detailed manner later, you will be getting a situation where a transfer function will be attained. What is a transfer function? It is going to be a one where if I am able to get a relationship between, if I am able to get a relationship between output to input, here in this case the variable to be controlled is H. H by Qi, if you you can just go on for it, which we can solve it later, this will be equivalent to R divided by tau is plus 1, where tau will be equivalent to R into A. Just you can remember, so that's enough. So this is a mathematical mode. Now going into the concluding concept which I would like to put forward. The concluding concept here, what I would like to put forward is correlating to your control systems about process control. So what is the concluding remark here? Now I am in a position to decide what will be the content of the block. For this level system, we have made a simple decision. That is, what is the transfer function? If transfer function is made, what is the meaning? It is a relationship between the output to input. So that way, what's the meaning here? If I want to control this height, I can measure it with the help of a sensor. In this case, it was a level transmitter, which could be taken for the purpose of finding out the error. How do I find out the error? In our case, we had a set point. What was the set point? 1 meter. So based upon that, I would like to know the difference between the current value to the existing value. That error will be given to the controller. In our case, the controller was a processor. This will give an input to the valve, and the valve will make a change in the inflow. This, if it is happening automatically, is the simplest form of process control. What we are going to study in this entire subject over a span of 5 units, which we can have some course outcome also fixed, is in the first unit we will study on how to get this model for level, temperature, pressure, flow. Various case studies. Then we will also see something about what is the meaning of a servo control, regulatory control, what is the meaning of a batch process, etc. In the second unit, we will go in detail about how this controller is going to get designed. Thereby, how it is going to be acting only as a P controller, only as a P plus I controller, then as a PID controller. Later, we will look into the simplest form, a simple feedback loop. How this loop can be a little bit made more complicated? It can be a cascaded form of control, it can be a ratio type of control, it can be what is going to be called as a feed forward with feedback control, etc. So, what are the various types which is going to be available there? Then we can look into exclusively on this valve. What are the various valve characteristics? How the valve characteristics could be analyzed? What are the types in which it can be going, classification, all those aspects can be put forward. Finally, in the last unit, we will go on for application of this some complex unit operations. Unit operations like a boiler, a distillation coil, how these things are going to get applied. Friends, this is a very interesting subject, process control. We have a good laboratory, a process control lab. If you are capable of understanding all these aspects, well, you can do projects without any cost. You can make number of publications. The aim of the department, as well as my personal wish to all of you here, is get into the habit of understanding some concepts, enjoy the concepts, implement the same with some resources available here, convert it into potential projects. Winning in some competition is going to be there. Convert these projects to potential publications, which will give you an idea on outcome-based education. This is only a small intro, just I had a small pep on how a level can be considered for the very simplest possible of control. And I would like to put forward, you know, my